If you've been doing a search to study abroad, you definitely know that UK school fees is very expensive. And so getting that £10,000 scholarship was like a huge burden lifted off my shoulders. Anyway, you're welcome back again to another video on my YouTube channel. My name is Parisia, and if you're new here, thank you for coming, and I hope you subscribe and join the family. And to my returning subscribers, thank you for always coming back. I appreciate the love. I told a couple of people that I won a £10,000 scholarship from Office of Students in the UK. £10,000 is no joke. Anyway, so I'm here to give you the gist on what the scholarship is about and how I finally got the scholarship after waiting for 5 months. 5 months after applying. Yeah, so let's get right into the video. So, I'm going to be reading some criteria from my computer. So what's the scholarship all about? The name of the scholarship is Postgraduate Conversion Courses in Data Science and Artificial Intelligence. So, backstory, I applied to the University of Essex to study data science. I didn't particularly choose which of the data sciences I want to study. So I got 3 offers, data science with placement, data science and its application, and then applied data science. And I mistakenly chose applied data science, you know. I wanted data science with placement. But then, because that one comes with more like extended visa to stay in the UK, because the second year is for placement, so you obviously need you need an extra visa. However, the school doesn't even help you get placement. You have to do all the work and get your placement. So when I chose applied data science, I sent the school an email that I was actually selecting data science with placement, but then they came back and told me that I wasn't eligible for the data science. I wasn't qualified for data science with its placement. But then God has his own way of working things out. So after that, when the school gave me the offer and then I confirmed my offer, they gave me on the admission letter, there was a part that said stated that scholarship and funding opportunity. So I clicked on that, and then I chanced on Postgraduate Conversion Courses in Data Science and Artificial Intelligence scholarship offer. The thing is that it is not open to everyone. It is actually for particular courses. So if you are studying applied data science and its application, or you are studying MSc Artificial Intelligence and application, that is when you can actually apply for this particular scholarship. So that was a backstory. Even though I didn't know how I was going to fund it, I had still made a decision that I was still going to go to school with back and forth in getting funding opportunities and all of that. I still decided that I was going to go back to school because the course models are interesting. They're something I like. They're practical. That's something I've always wanted to do, something practical. And it's going to complement my study of finance and investment. So yeah, data and finance and investment. Let's see how this journey pans out. Anyway, back to what the scholarship scheme is all about. So the scholarship scheme was put in place by Office of Students to address the shortage of AI and data specialists in the UK. And then they also wanted to increase diversity. After you apply, you don't apply directly on Office of Students website. It's a school specific, so some schools would require that you apply after getting the offer, and I think some also, when you apply to the school and you get the offer and you are qualified, they can enroll you on that. But for University of Essex, I had to apply separately, and so it's a £10,000 scholarship. And so I'm going to read out the eligibility criteria, and then if you fall within that and you are considering coming to school or furthering your studies in this direction, you can go for it. Are you a female applicant? You take disabled applicants, Black or British Caribbean, mixed white and Black Caribbean, mixed white and Black African, other Black background, applicants from Pula Q1 and Q2, care experience applicant, Gypsy, Roma or traveler applicant, refugee applicant, or applicants from military family, veteran family of military personnel. Yeah, so these are some of the eligibility criteria, and you should have gained an offer to study, either a conditional or unconditional offer to study any of the courses I mentioned in one of the eligible schools. So I'm going to read out the schools that are under the scholarship scheme. I think every year it changes because the schools bid for the opportunity to give scholarship to their applicants. Yeah, so it's not like if your school is on the list, automatically the following year the school is going to be on the list. They bid for it every year. So before you apply to the university, just make sure that you check if they are giving out that scholarship for that particular year, for September, October, or January intake. My school does October intake and January intake. So if you want to go to the University of Essex to study any of these, you can check out on their website. It's actually on their website. Everything is on their website. Yeah, you can email the school to find out more information. They are very responsive. Schools that are eligible as at the time I'm making this video. So University of Essex, my school, Aston University, Birkbeck University of London, Birmingham City University, Coventry University, Lancaster University, Loughborough University, forgive me, Newcastle University, Nottingham Trent University, Queen of Mary University of London, Sheffield, Hallam University, Solent University, University of Birmingham, University of Bradford, University of Bath, University of Exeter, University of Hull, University of Keighley, University of Liverpool, University of Suffolk, University of Sunderland, University of Sussex, University of West Bristol, University of England, University of Wolverhampton. So for my university, when you apply, when you get the offer and you go on their website, you can actually see the forms on the website. You just have to fill out the form and then email it back to appropriate email depending on which of the courses you actually studied. So mine, my eligibility criteria was a female applicant, black of black British African. So I'm an African, so I qualify for it. And don't forget that this is like a conversion course. So usually if you're coming to study this program, they don't expect that you have like a background in IT or programming or anything. Like it's not, you can come from all angles. I have no background in IT whatsoever. My whole life I've been doing business, accounting, commerce, all of that. I don't have any IT background. So this course is actually like a conversion course for you. So if you are thinking of switching careers or coming into the data field, yeah, you can apply, you can look into it and then apply for this. So selecting which of the criteria you fall under, they expect that you write a personal statement. Of course, they won't give you the money on a silver platter. They will want you to give them a reason why you think you deserve this scholarship offer, because other people also need it. So you have to write, I don't know for other universities, but I can speak to University of Essex because that's the school I am in. The deadline for applying for the scholarship is 31st July. I got my offer in April and then I submitted my application in May, like on 5th May. That's when I submitted my application and I had to wait. On their website, they say that you're going to get a feedback by 5th of August. So after 5th of August, I wasn't getting any response. So I waited till like September and then, no, ending of August, and then I sent them an email that I haven't heard anything from them, blah, blah, blah. But they didn't get back to me. And around that time too, I was just wondering if I was really going to go to the school, because honestly, funding was like a big deal. I didn't know how I was going to fund the schooling. So I waited till the final. I had a conversation with my family and then I decided that I was going to go. So I decided to go and I applied for my visa and all of that somewhere around September. And 2nd October, I was in school. So I sent the school an email to find out what's up with the application that I put in. I haven't gotten any feedback yet and it's been over a month. Like, what's happening? But I didn't get any feedback. So when I came to school during the freshers fair, I saw the funding team stand, their stand, and I went there and I'm like, excuse me, I sent an email to follow up on the application that I put in for the £10,000 scholarship, but then I haven't gotten any feedback yet. And the lady told me that, okay, it could be that I'm on the reserve list, that is why I haven't received any feedback. I'm like, okay. But she was like, they'll get back to me. And prior to that, I had spoken with a friend who didn't get the scholarship. She was like, she didn't get it, and the department sent her an email to tell her that she didn't get the scholarship. So I'm like, okay, since she didn't get feedback and the funding team is telling me I may probably be on the reserve list, let me still keep my hopes alive and pray. And so after the freshers fair, I went to my department like the following week to go and ask them that I haven't gotten any feedback. And the department told me that Normally, if you've not received any email from them, it means that it's still with the funding team, and then they're the ones going to make a final decision on it. So if you don't get it, the email is going to come directly from my department, which is the maths department. So since I haven't gotten any feedback, I could go back to the funding team and do a follow-up, or I could wait and they also follow up on it for me. Okay, because I needed the money, I took steps to go. So let's assume I went to my department on Thursday and to go and make the inquiries. I went there and they told me that I could go to the funding team to go and follow up, or they would follow up on me. The next day, I went to the funding team and then I told the lady that, excuse me, ma'am, I sent an email, blah, blah, blah. I've not gotten any feedback yet, so I'm here to follow up. And she was like, oh, you got a scholarship of 4,500. And 4,500 is what they give to everybody. Like if you're an African and you apply, your CGPA from your undergrad is good. They give you a 4,500 scholarship discount. Like, fees discounts automatically. She was like, you got that one. And I'm like, sorry, ma'am, that is not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the £10,000 scholarship. So she actually didn't know what I was talking about. So she told me to write my name and write the name of the scholarship scheme for her to check for me. And then she went to the back office and came back. She was like, you're on the reserve list, so we are definitely going to get back to you. Okay, that was at least some good news. Fast forward to the following week. Just before I went for a lecture, I was going to the lab. I went to the library, opened my tuition fee, and I'm like, God, how am I going to pay the school fees? Because I was left with about, the school fees in total is £19,740, and I had paid £5,080. So I was asking God, how am I going to pay the remaining amount? And then I closed it. The thing about it is that you don't pay your school fees at once. It's divided into three. So if you are going to pay in three installments, so you pay the £3,000 for your cars, then the remaining £3,000 and whatever for the first semester before you are enrolled, and then you pay the rest in two installments. Okay. So I was asking my God, I was like, God, how am I going to pay the school fees? And then I closed it and then I went to the lab. I was in the lab. And then I was in the computer lab, and then I received an email. I opened, guess what? It was an email from the funding team, and they were like, congratulations upon considerations, blah, blah, blah. You have been selected as one of the 20 applicants who won the scholarship. Good. But come and see how I was. Like, I had to run out of the lab. I was so excited. I sent my family a voicemail. It was like a big relief to me. Cool thing. Like, I was super excited. Yeah. So that's basically it. I put up the work, I followed up, and God graced it with his blessings. Like, God made a way for me. Yeah, so that brings me to the end of today's video. If you enjoyed it or you need more information, as I say, you can leave it in the comment section and I'll definitely get back to you. And I hope to see you in my next video. If you haven't subscribed, this is the best time to hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, leave a comment, share, and I'm definitely going to see you in my next video. Till then.